Folks, it has been 10 years since the body of Kendrick Johnson, then 17, was found inside of a mat at a Georgia high school gymnasium. No one has been charged with his death. Many believe there was a cover-up. Lowndes County Sheriff's investigators concluded that Johnson died in a freak accident, stuck upside down and unable to breathe while trying to retrieve a shoe that fell inside the upright mat. The parents of Kendrick Johnson have filed a lawsuit against the Georgia Bureau of Investigation and the Lowndes County Sheriff's Office about what they claim is, quote, false information connected to the investigation into his death. This has been a story that has gotten a lot of attention over the years. And we, of course, focused on this thing as well. And it's just, again, one of those stories that it still sort of boggles the mind. Jonathan Burrs is the Johnson family spokesman. Glad to have you on the show, Jonathan. So this has been an ongoing saga. And so exactly when they say false information, what do they mean? What does the family mean?
Well, what they mean is the information that the Sheriff's Department and the Georgia Bureau of Investigations has been presenting to the public is inconsistent with the material facts and the material evidences. All of the facts contradict what they are presenting to the public. And this is evidence that they collected and or staged. Their own evidence contradicts their testimonies and the synopsis from the sheriff's most recent investigation.
And so what do they want the outcome to be? Because with this lawsuit, it still does not get them closer to finding out who actually killed him if there was foul play involved.
Well, the evidence certainly supports that there was foul play. And because of the way the case has been handled in the past, at this point, this is what they're left with, attacking the injustice that continues to interfere with their civil rights and adversely affects them every day.
It's still sort of, and I guess for me, I still never understood how if a shoe was in a mat and it was at the bottom of the mat, why would somebody climb into the mat to get the shoe when literally you could just move the mat and the shoe's right there?
Yeah. So if you look at what the other kids have been saying, kids stored their shoes over on top of these mats, whatever. They apparently had a process that they would go through to retrieve these shoes without incident. Only this time does this process seem to not work. That is, if you believe what the official statements have been. Of course, the material evidence paints a totally different picture.
Again, it's just one of those stories that still just, I sort of just shake my head still trying to understand exactly how they arrived at all of this. Lawsuit has been filed. Hopefully, this family will get some answers. And well, we just hope so. Jonathan, we appreciate it. Thanks so very much.